हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल क्लिनिकल बायोकेमिस्ट्री बाय डॉक्टर पी के प्रभाकर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट ग्लूकोज टॉलरेंस टेस्ट। दिस ग्लूकोज टॉलरेंस टेस्ट इज आल्सो नोन एज जीटीटी टेस्ट। लिटरल मीनिंग ऑफ दिस ग्लूकोज टॉलरेंस टेस्ट, एज यू विल सी द नेम, इट्स कॉल्ड एज ग्लूकोज टॉलरेंस टेस्ट, मीन्स हाउ योर बॉडी इज गोइंग टू टॉलरेट द ग्लूकोज। सो ग्लूकोज टॉलरेंस टेस्ट मीन्स द एबिलिटी ऑफ आवर बॉडी टू यूटिलाइज ग्लूकोज इन द ब्लड सर्कुलेशन। So we are going to give the extra load of glucose to our body, and then we are going to see how this glucose is going to be metabolized by our body. So glucose tolerance normally decreases in certain specific situations, like in case of diabetes mellitus, in case of impaired glucose tolerance, and some other case of like endocrine disorders, like hyperthyroidism or hyperpituitarism or hyperadrenalism. In these cases, normally this tolerance decreases, means your body is unable to utilize glucose properly. So this glucose tolerance test, basically it is a laboratory test to check how your body breaks down or going to utilize or going to metabolize this blood glucose, and how quickly it is going to clear the extra glucose, extra burden of glucose from the blood circulations. It is one of the test, one of the tool which normally used to diagnose or differentiate pre-diabetes, diabetes, insulin resistance, and reactive hypoglycemic conditions. This test is very sensitive to diagnose diabetes. This is, you can call it, one of the better test compared to the normal glucose test to evaluate or to diagnose diabetes. Not only that one, by this test you can also differentiate the normal renal glycosuria, diabetes mellitus, or impaired glucose tolerance. So if you see this one, this test is used, I have already told you, used to test to diagnose diabetes, insulin resistance, impaired beta cell functions, yeah, impaired insulin activity, and sometimes renal hypoglycemic, and certain endocrine functions also I have told you, like in case of hyperpituitarism or hyperthyroidism or hyperadrenalism, in those cases also we can differentiate. This GTT is most commonly done to check the how glucose is going to be tolerated in case of, especially in case of pregnancy also, that is gestational diabetes mellitus. Many variations of GTT have been devised, has been suggested over the years for various purposes, and later on we will see all those variations, all those different types of GTT test with different standard dosage of glucose and different routes of administrations, different intervals and duration of samplings, various substance measures, like just I'm going to tell you name here, and later on we will discuss those things. When we are going to talk about the standard dose of glucose, so how much glucose load is going to given to the patient, so on the basis of that one we are having basically three different type of GTT tests, like 50 gram, 75 gram, and 100 gram, that we will see later on. Then on the basis of different routes of administration, we are having oral GTT test, which is the most commonly done test. And second one is IV GTT test, intravenous glucose tolerance test. Different intervals, we are having 1 hour GTT test, 2 hour GTT test, we are having 3 hour GTT test. So depending on these different variables, we are having different type of GTT test. If you'll go and see the basic history of the GTT test, the first time it was described by Jerome W. Kahn in 1923. This test was based on the previous work by another scientist, that is A.T.B. Jacobson, in 1913 for the determination of carbohydrate ingestions results in the blood glucose fluctuations and variations, and premise that the normal patient fed glucose, when you are going to give glucose load to a normal person, normal patient, will rapidly come back to the normal level after a certain intervals. First it will go, it will rise, it will go up to the peak, and then it will come back to the normal level. So that is the GTT test. Later on so we will see that graph. Since 1970s, the WHO and other organizations interested in diabetes agreed on the standard dose and durations. So basically we are having two different type of GTT test depending on the route of administration. So first one is called as oral glucose tolerance test, and second one is called as IV GTT test, intravenous glucose tolerance test. Now, which type of person or who need to go for GTT test? So there are certain conditions when doctor normally suggests to person to go for GTT test. So all women who had previously diagnosed for GTT, gestational diabetes, roughly between 24th to 28th week of their pregnancy to detect complications. Or doctor may also recommend that someone have this test if they had pre-diabetics or diabetes, or had gestational diabetes during her previous pregnancy, or if that lady had given birth of a baby who was obese or more than 4.1 kg or younger than 25 year of age and overweight before getting pregnant. So in this case also, doctor normally suggests that lady should go for GTT test or to diagnose pre-diabetic and diabetes. Now, there are before every test, we need to give some kind of instruction to the patient. So that is called as preparation. So here also we need to give a specific suggestion, a specific instruction to the patient. So first, a patient should eat a balanced diet, which roughly contains 150 gram of carbohydrate per day for 3 days before the test. So he should eat normal food, whatever he is eating. He should avoid certain specific food which contains higher amount of carbohydrate, like fruits, breads, cereals, grains, rice, some starchy vegetables like potato, beans, because these contains high amount of glucose and it will affect your glucose metabolic processes. The person should, or the patient should not drink or eat or smoke or exercise very strenuously for 8 hours before the test. If you are going to take, if a patient is going to take certain specific type of prescribed medicine or non-prescribed medicine, so those things need to tell the doctors, and doctor may instruct which medicine need to stop, which medicine need not to stop. Normally, doctor will instruct you, will give you information that those medicines which is going to affect your glucose metabolic processes, that medicine need to be stopped. This glucose tolerance diagnostic test may take up roughly 3 to 4 hours. So patient, when person coming for GTT test, he should come well prepared for this 3 to 4 hour time. Since activity can interfere with the test result, so you may not be asked, you may be asked to sit properly, not moving, not walking normally. What is going to happen whenever a person is waiting at certain place? He starts walking, brisk walking, that also going to affect your glucose metabolic process. If you are going to play some kind of mental games, that also going to affect your glucose metabolic process. So normally you should sit quietly during the entire test. Do not eat during the test. You may drink only water which does not contain any kind of glucose. And the patient must retain seated quietly for 30 minutes before and during the test. A patient may require to remain in the collection center until the whole process of GTT test will be completed. Patient can come with some kind of reading material because he has to wait there for 3 to 4 hours or other activity to pass the times. If feel unwell during the test, please inform the blood collection staff and he will tell you certain instruction, or you may lie down there. There should be no acute significant illness for 2 weeks prior to the test. That you have to notice and you have to tell the doctor. Due to the nature of test, testing is generally done in the morning because we are going to collect fasting blood sample also. So that's why we require normally 8 to 12 hour fasting. So normally it will be preferred in the morning only. Before drinking the glucose, please inform the collection staff if you have any kind of allergies. So this was the normal process, normal preparation for the patients. Now we'll see how this test is going to be done. So normally we are going to take a zero baseline blood sample that we are going to call fasting blood sample. So as soon as you are coming to the labs, roughly after 8 hours of fasting, 0 hour sample, blood sample will be taken. Then a patient is going to be given a measured dose of glucose solution to drink within 5 minutes of time frame. Now this glucose amount, how much glucose is to be given, that is going to be decided by body weight. So normally what we are going to talk, the most common test is 75 gram glucose test. In that case, we are going to calculate 1.75 gram per kg body weight. And maximum amount we can give a person, that 75 gram. So like if you are having a person whose body weight is 75 kg, so that time you cannot, you are not going to multiply 75 to 1.75, because then it will be more than 100 grams. So that much glucose we are not going to give. So maximum you can give 75 gram glucose in this common test. So by this formula we are going to calculate it, especially in case of child. And if you are having a 20 kg person, there you cannot give 75 gram, there you have to multiply with this one. So maximum amount should be 75 gram, and normally we are going to multiply with this formula. Once you have given this glucose to a person to drink within the 5-minute time frame, then blood is going to be taken and urine will also be collected at interval of glucose taken. So blood glucose and urine will be collected after every hours or every half an hours. So commonly we are going to collect after every hours, but preferably it will be after every 30 minutes. If you want to measure, you can measure insulin level also sometimes. If you want to see how much insulin, how insulin is going to pattern, means what is the usual pattern of insulin release. The interval and number of sample may vary according to the purpose of test. Just now I have told you, commonly we are going to take 0 hour sample, 1 hour sample and 2 hour samples. But preference better will be if we will collect the blood sample after every 30 minutes. The for simple diabetes screening, the most important sample is for 2 hour test, and the 0 and 2 hour sample may be the only one collected. Now type of GTT test depending on how much glucose we are going to give. So we have three different type of GTT test, that is 50 gram, 75 gram or 100 gram. So in case of 50 gram, we are going to give 50 gram of glucose through oral route, that's why it's called OGGT, oral glucose tolerance test. In case of 75 gram, we are going to give 75 gram glucose in maximum. In case of 100 gram, we are OGGT, we are going to give 100 gram of glucose. These three are three different kind of tests and done at three different time durations. So when we are going to perform 50 gram of GTT test, we are going to collect blood sample after an hour. So 0 hour sample and 1 hour sample. If normal we are going to give 75 gram GTT test, so we are going to collect blood sample after every 30 minutes for 2 hours. Commonly we are doing 0, 1 and 2, but this is the best if you are going to collect 4 to 5 samples so that you can plot a better graph. And in case of 100 gram OGTT test, we are going to collect blood sample after every hours for 3 hours. So these are the three different kind of test we are having. Now, so I have told you 75 gram oral glucose is going to be recommended by WHO to all the adults. In for the babies, for the children, normally we are going to multiply with 1.75 kg gram per kg body weight. So depending on the body weight, we are going to multiply with 1.75, and then that much amount of glucose will be dissolved in water and given to the patient who has to go for GTT test. The dose should be completed drink within the 5 minutes of time durations. A variance is often used during the pregnancy, because in case of pregnancy we are not going to give extra burden of glucose. So that time normally preferred test is 50 gram GTT test, and we are going to collect only blood sample. If this is not going to be normal, then we can go for the other test, that is 100 gram for 3 hour test. In case of United Kingdom, normal practices, we are not going to give this 75 gram glucose. We are going to give an energy drink that is called as a Lucozade, that which contains roughly 394 ml of energy drink, and it is having a sufficient amount of glucose that will be given drink to the patients. Similarly, in case of Portugal, a standard glucose load is going to be given in the laboratory, which contains 200 ml of fluid in a PET bottle. The name of this one is called as Top Star. So this is a best known brand of Top Star and produced by Portugal. So different countries having different type of patterns. Roughly we are going to give 75 gram of glucose maximum, and in case of kids it will be multiplied by 1.75 gram per kg body weight. So when you are going to collect the blood sample after every half an hour or every hours depending on the test, we are going to get some kind of results. The normal results is, in case of 1 hour or 50 gram OGTT test, If blood glucose level is coming after 1 hour, 140 mg per dl or less, it will be considered as normal. In case of 75 gram or 2 RGTT test, fasting level should be 70 to 110, that is normal. After 1 hour, it should be at the peak, I have told you, it will go up to peak and then it will come back to normal. So it can go up to 200 mg per dl. And after second hours, it will come back to the normal value, that will be around 126 to 150. If we are going for 100 gram OGTT test for 3 hour test, then these are the normal value. So this is all known as normal value. If we are going to get these value or less than this value, it will be considered as normal result. But when glucose level will be higher than this one, it will be considered as abnormal value. Like if we are going to give 75 gram of glucose, so this is normal glucose tolerance test value. After 75 gram we have given, so we are going to collect 3 samples, fasting 1 hour and 2 hour. If it is less than 100 mg per dl, it is fine during fasting. After 1 hour, if it will be 184 or less than 184, it will be normal. And 2 hours, it will be more than less than 140, it will be considered as normal, because the pattern is it increases to the peak and then it is coming back to the normal value. Here, in case of gestational diabetes, in case of women, if we are going to perform 75 gram or 100 gram, these value are called as the normal value. Anything beyond that one, anything above that one, is considered as the abnormal value. So this is a graph where we have plotted, this is a 2 hour OGTT, where this blood sample for this person, this is the normal value when at the 0 hour time or fasting, the glucose level was less than 100. When we have given glucose, so it increases roughly up to 126 and it will come back to the normal range in the below the 100. So this is a normal subject. In case of diabetic person, this glucose level was slightly higher than the 100, so it is slightly in the hyperglycemic signs. It increases, but it didn't come back to the normal value. So it is called as diabetic subject. Better if you see this graph, where this is the normal graph and this is the diabetic graph, which coming back to the normal, but not below the normal value or near to the normal value. It is above the normal value. So always after 2 hours, after 3 hours, after 4 hours, after 5 hours also, the glucose level will not come back to the with normal range. Normal range is 70 to 126. So in this range, never this glucose comes. So always it will be higher side only. So this is diabetic conditions. Here you can understand the basic differences between the three category. One is a normal GTT. This is a normal person where glucose level at the 0 hours fasting will be less than 100. It increases at the 1 hour, it will be at the peak, roughly 150, and then it will come back to the normal value within 2 hours. In this case, the glucose level was roughly 125-126, that was normally pre-diabetic cases. It increases up to peak within the 1 hour. It starts coming back to the normal, but it didn't come to the normal value within the 2 hours. Maybe after 3 hours, it will come back to the normal value. So it takes slightly higher time, slightly more time than the normal person, so that glucose level will come back to the normal value. So in this case, it is not diabetic person. It is called as impaired diabetic or moderate diabetic or pre-diabetic, you can call it. So here glucose level pattern is showing that glucose level will come back to the normal, but it will take slightly higher time. In the third case, if you'll see here, the first dose, fasting dose, is still more than 200. So it is still diabetic conditions. It increases, so it will be in the peak and it will be above only. Its pattern is not showing that it will come back to the normal within the normal time durations. So these are those same graph. In one case it will be for glucose, in another case it will be for insulin level. Now here I am going to show you three different cases for three different patients. Now if you see in this case, the fasting blood sample, if it is 7, this is the normal value, this is the result for patient. If you see the fasting blood sample, that is 70 to 110 is the normal, but it is slightly 115, means it is pre-diabetic conditions. At 1 hour, it rises to 135, and it come back to the normal within the 2 hours, means around 100. So in this is the normal person. If you'll see the in urine also, neither during fasting nor at the first hour or second hour, urine contains the glucose level. So no any kind of glycosuria is there. Normal, if glucose level will be more than 180 mg per dl in our blood, then it will come to the urine. So that is called as glycosuria, because this is the renal threshold value. So in this case, it is not above 180, so urine does not have any kind of glucose content. In the second case, if you'll see the patient first sample, it was 115, the normal pre-diabetic conditions. In the first hour, it will be at the highest level, peak, 220. But after 2 hours, again it came back to the normal value. So in this case also, the person is normal. But if you'll see the case at the 1 hour time, because it is more than 180 mg per dl, so after in the first hour sample, urine also contains glucose because of it crosses the renal threshold value. In the fasting, in case of first second hour, because it is less than 180, so it didn't come there. Now if you'll see in the third case, this is the third patient. So 115 is the normal value during the fasting. At first hour, it will be 250. So at the peak, within the at the end of second hour, it should come back to the normal. Means it should be less than around 122 or 126 to 140, 150. But it is still 220. So in this case, we are going to confirm that this person is diabetic. Or if pattern can show you, it can be impaired. So here in this first hour also and second hour also, we can see the urine have glucose content. So on the basis of this glucose value on the graph, you can confirm that which type of case is there. It is diabetic, it is now normal, or it is impaired. Now certain specific conditions, like in case of pregnancy, how we are going to do it. So according to American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists, recommend the two-step procedures, where the first step is a 50 gram glucose test. In 1 hour, results are equal or greater than 130 to 140 if it is followed by 100 gram of glucose test. So first we are going to conduct 50 gram. If at the end of 1 hour, if glucose value will come more than 140, then we are going for second test, that is 100 gram glucose test. And the diagnosis of gestational diabetes is then defined by the glucose level exceeding the cutoff value at two level intervals. Before fasting, it should be less than 95, and after 1 hour, 2 hour and 3 hour, because we are going to conduct 1 hour 100 gram, so we have to take for 3 hours, three samples. So this is the cutoff value. If glucose level come above this one, we can confirm that gestational diabetes is there. So this is some of the risk factors of gestational diabetes. Already I have told you, if mother has given overweight baby in the previous pregnancy, she has diabetes, she is obese, or she has any other family history of diabetes, in those conditions normally we are going to suspect that mother may have gestational diabetes complications. And these are the risk factors which normally increases the chances of getting gestational diabetes mellitus. Higher glucose level may be caused because of certain reasons, like either it will be because of diabetes also, it may be because of gestational diabetes, it may be because of hyperthyroidism, or some medicines such as corticosteroids, niacin, Dilantin, some other diuretics, which normally increases the glucose productions, decreases glucose utilization. So in these cases, glucose level rises in our body. So large amount of hormones such as cortisol in the blood, that is also going to increase the glucose level, and or some kind of inherited disease such as hemochromatosis, which also increases glucose decreases glucose utilization and increases glucose synthesis. So in all these cases, our blood glucose level rises. Like in this case, glucose level rises, but it is not the case of diabetes. In this case, this is the endocrine disease, but it is not a diabetes. So we have to differentiate these pattern after. In certain cases, glucose level may cause decreases, like certain medicines such as medicines used to treat diabetes, any antidiabetics, hypoglycemic medicines, some blood pressure medicines such as propranolol, some medicines for depression such as isocarboxazid, decreased production of hormones like cortisol. I have told you cortisol or aldosterone normally increases. So if we don't have these hormones, so glucose level will come back to the normal, come back to the less than the normal. If we are having any issue with the thyroid glands or underactive pituitary glands, a tumor or any kind of issue in the pancreas, so that no sufficient amount of insulin will be produced, so glucose will not be, means glucagon will not be produced, or it will affect the other functions. Or in case of liver disease, normally liver increases glucose production, so if we are having liver disease also, then also glucose will not be produced or utilized by a body, so in that case glucose level may decreases. Now there are certain factors which affects the test, like smoking, alcohol intake, recent surgery, illness or infectious disease, weight loss during the dietings, long period of bed rest such as hospitalization of illness. So these are the certain conditions in which case which affects our test, GTT test. So if a person who comes for the test, see, he should not smoke, he should not have taken any kind of alcohol during the last few days, he should not have gone for recent surgery or not on certain specific medicines. He should not only be dieting, because I have told you during the preparation that he should eat normal food for the last 3 days. So these are the factors which affect our tests. This is the three different factors when we are going for OGTT test. There are factors which can be pre-analytical or analytical or post-analytical which will affect your tests. When you are going for pre-analytical, it can be physiological, it will be related to your testing factors, like hydration, exercise, stroke or gastric emptying. These are the normal physiological factors which affect the OGTT test. Or if you see the pre-diabetic test, test related factors like storage and transport of blood sample, yet sample, timing of fasting, glucose load, preparatory diets or collecting tubes. So these may affect glucose, these are called as pre-analytical, because before test. During analytical test, we can have traceability or imprecision or biasness that will affect. Or post-analytical is reporting in the result, identification of the critical results and interpretation of the results. So these are the overall factors which affect our GTT test. So normally when we are going to perform OGTT test, we are going to take blood, fasting, and then after every hours. If we are having 50 gram glucose OGTT test, then only one sample. If we are having 75 gram, then two samples, 1 hour and 2 hours. If we are having 100 gram, then three samples along with the urine, and we are going to measure the glucose and we are going to plot the graph, and then we are going to see the pattern. So this is all about the glucose tolerance test. Hope you have understood it. If you have any query, any comments, please write in the comment box. Your all the suggestions you can write in the comment box. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe it. If you like the video, press the like button and share and subscribe it. So thank you very much. Have a nice day.